Hello, welcome back to Shakespeare. For a change of pace today, we're going to hear from Cardinal Wolsey in Act 3, Scene 2 of Henry VIII, because we've been hearing from him a lot lately. Act 3, Scene 2 is really long, and a lot happens to Cardinal Wolsey. So it starts out with us learning that nobody likes him, that he wrote a letter to the Pope saying that the king shouldn't be allowed to get divorced and then remarried, and that the king has come into possession of that letter. We learn that the king has already gotten married. We see the king and the cardinal chat for a little while, and the king is like making a big fuss about the cardinal's financial statements. And then the king is like, are you loyal to me? Do you like me? Do you respect me? All that sort of stuff. And the cardinal's like, yes, of course I do. And the king's like, see, everybody heard him say that he loves me. And here, read all of this stuff. And yesterday we had the cardinal sort of freaking out a little bit, because he started looking through the stack of papers that the king was looking through, and first he saw that the king was looking at the cardinal's financial statements, and that was a bad thing because the cardinal's been saving up money to buy himself a popedom. And then while he's trying to fix that, he realizes that the letter that he had sent to the Pope was also in the packet, which was a really stupid thing to do, and now he's basically done for. And then after that monologue is done, Suffolk and Surrey and Norfolk and Lord Chamberlain come back in, and they're like, you're under house arrest, and that little medal thing that you have, M-E-D-A-L thing that you have, we need that back. And the king is like, wait, by whose order is this happening? And they're like, the king. And he's like, why should I take your word for it? And they're like, why shouldn't you take our word for it? And he says, till I find more than will or words to do it, I mean your malice, no, officious lords, I dare and must deny it. Now I feel of what coarse metal ye are molded. Envy, how eagerly ye follow my disgraces, as if it fed ye, and how sleek and wanton ye appear in every thing may bring my ruin. Follow your envious courses, men of malice. You have Christian warrant for them, and no doubt in time will find their fit rewards. That seal you ask with such a violence, the king, mine, and your master, with his own hand gave me, bade me enjoy it with the place and honors during my life, and to confirm his goodness, tied it by letters patents. Now, who'll take it? So basically what he's saying is, I don't take your word for it. The king needs to tell me himself that this is a thing, because when he gave me my position and this little metal thing that you're asking back as you put me under house arrest, when he gave all of this to me, he did it with every conceivable like binding agreement that he could give it to me, so whatever. And they're like, yeah, but he said we need to give it back. And he's like, well, then the king can come and get it himself. And then Surrey jumps in to this whole thing, because Surrey was Buckingham's son-in-law, I believe. Buckingham being the dude who was killed at the very beginning because the cardinal set him up on trial and got people to come in, his servants to come in and say that he was a traitor to the crown and all that sort of thing. So Surrey really doesn't like Cardinal Wolsey, and they start getting into it. And we're going to, in the next couple days, we're going to get to hear snippets of that argument, and that'll be fun. So yeah, I'll see you tomorrow for more. Mwah.